talk about the IMA's 24-hour band call from 6 a.m. to Sunday 6 a.m. as far as this protest, this band is concerned. And only emergency and casualty wards that have been allowed to work. Owing to the circumstances, there has been a list of demands also that has been kept forth as far as seeking. When it comes to the safety of healthcare professionals, that should be the topmost priority. This is something that has now been looked upon on part of this band that has also been called. There have been several other medical organizations as well who have resumed their protests. Let me go across to Akansha right now. Akansha, tell us more about this band, because there has been, as far as a list of demands that has also been kept forth in front of the center as well, to take note of when it comes to the safety and security of our medical professionals.
Well, you see, as far as the Indian Medical Association is concerned, earlier they were quite reluctant to announce a strike because they were saying that they don't want to take any knee-jerk reaction. But after the vandalism at the RG Kerr Hospital day before yesterday, a lot of things have changed in the last 48 hours. IMA has announced a nationwide strike starting today for the next 24 hours. And FODA, which had earlier taken back the strike, have now resumed it again. I'm currently standing outside the RML Hospital here in the national capital, and I'm currently standing outside the emergency care services area, and the services in fact here continue. You can see a lot of people are coming here, but other than this, the OPDs are shut today. The other departments are also currently shut today, not just the hospitals but the labs and also the clinics, that includes the government or any private clinic in the entire country. They all have been shut. This is a call that has been given by the Indian Medical Association. But here in the national capital, you can see the visuals here at the RML Hospital. The emergency services continue, not just here, but across all the government and private hospitals across the country. Only the OPDs are shut today. And this is as per the call that has been given by the Indian Medical Association. As far as the resident doctor associations are concerned, yesterday they carried out the march. In fact, a lot of doctors also protested outside Nirman Bhavan. That is where the health ministry is situated. So the protests have definitely amplified in the last 48 hours after the vandalism took place. IMA has waded in. Other associations have also took to the streets. They will be carrying out a march to Jantar Mantar today as well. So in a way, we can see that now the doctors are seeking accountability after vandalism took place.
All right. For the moment, thank you very much, Akansha and Sabyasachi, for joining in. As the protests continue, on part of that, political updates that are also lined up on part of the investigation that is being done by the CBI.